did you say was looting this temple? He asked Hackbard. The Illuminati. The real force behind all communist and fascist movements. Whether you're aware of it or not, they're also already in control of the United States government. I thought everybody in your crowd was a right-winger. And I told you, spatial metaphors are inadequate in discussing politics today.
Hackbard interrupted.
Well, you sound like a gang of right-wingers. Up until the last minute, all I'd heard from you and your people was that the Illuminati were commies, or were behind the commies. Now you say they're behind fascism and behind the current government in Washington, too.
Hackbard laughed.
We came on like right-wing paranoids at first to see how you'd react. It was a test. And? You passed. You didn't believe us. That was obvious. But you kept your ears and your eyes open and were willing to listen. If you were a right-winger, we would have done our pro-communist rap. The idea is to find out if a new man or woman will listen, really listen, or just shut their minds at the first really shocking idea. I'm listening, but not uncritically. For instance, if the Illuminati control America already, what's the purpose of the assassination? Their grip on Washington is still pretty precarious. They've been able to socialize the economy. But if they showed their hand now and went totalitarian all the way, there would be a revolution. Middle readers would rise up with right-wingers and left libertarians, and the Illuminati aren't powerful enough to withstand that kind of massive revolution. But they can rule by fraud, and by fraud eventually acquire access to the tools they need to finish the job of killing off the Constitution. What sort of tools? More stringent security measures, universal electronic surveillance, no-knock laws, stop-and-frisk laws, government inspection of all first-class mail, automatic fingerprinting, photographing, blood tests, and urinalysis of any person arrested before he's charged with a crime. A law making it unlawful to resist even unlawful arrest. Laws establishing detention camps for potential subversives, gun control laws, restrictions on travel. The assassinations, you see, establish the need for such laws in the public mind. Instead of realizing that there is a conspiracy conducted by a handful of men, the people reason or are manipulated into reasoning that the entire populace must have its freedom restricted in order to protect the leaders. The people agree that they themselves can't be trusted. Targets for assassinations will be mavericks of left or right who are either not part of the Illuminati conspiracy or have been marked as unreliable. The Kennedy brothers and Martin Luther King, for example, were capable of mobilizing a somewhat libertarian left-right black-white populist movement. But the assassinations that have occurred so far are nothing to what will take place. The next wave will be carried out by the Mafia, who will be paid in Illuminati gold.
Not Moscow gold?
Said George with a smile.
The puppets in the Kremlin have no idea that they and the puppets in the White House are working for the same people. The Illuminati control all sorts of organizations and national governments without any of them being aware that others are also controlled. Each group thinks it's competing with the others, while actually each is playing its part in the Illuminati plan. Even the Morituri, the six-person affinity groups which splintered from the SDS Weathermen because the Weathermen seemed too cautious, are under the control of the Illuminati. They think they're working to bring down the government, but actually they are strengthening its hand. The Black Panthers are also infiltrated. Everything is infiltrated. At present rate, within the next few years, the Illuminati will have the American people under tighter surveillance than Hitler had the Germans. And the beauty of it is, the majority of the Americans will have been so frightened by Illuminati-backed terrorist incidents that they will beg to be controlled as a masochist begs for the whip.
George shrugged. Hackbar sounded like a typical paranoid. But there was this submarine and the strange events of the past few days.
So the Illuminati are conspiring to tyrannize the world, is that it? Do you trace them back to the First International? No. They're what happened when the Enlightenment of the 18th century collided with German mysticism. The correct name for the organization is Ancient Illuminated Seers of Bavaria. According to their own traditions, they were founded or revived in 1776 on May 1st by a man named Adam Weishaupt. Weishaupt was an unfraud Jesuit and a Mason. He taught that religious and national governments had to be overthrown and the world ruled by an elite of scientifically minded materialistic atheists to be held in trust for the masses of mankind who would eventually rule themselves when enlightenment became universal. But this was only Weishaupt's outer doctrine. There was also an inner doctrine, which was that power is an end in itself, and that Weishaupt and his closest followers would make use of the new knowledge being developed by scientists and engineers to seize control of the world. Back in 1776, things were run largely by the church and the feudal nobility, with the capitalists slowly getting a bigger and bigger piece of the pie. Weishaupt declared that these groups were obsolete, and it was time for an elite with a monopoly on scientific and technological knowledge to seize power. Instead of producing a democratic society as the outer doctrine promised, the ancient illuminated seers of Bavaria would saddle mankind with a dictatorship that would last forever. Well, it would be logical enough that someone around that time would think of that,
Sir George.
And who more likely than a Mason who was an unfraught Jesuit? You recognize that what I tell you is relatively plausible,
Sir Hagbard.
That's a good sign. A sign that it's plausible?
Laughed George.
No. A sign that you're the kind of person I'm always looking for. Another thing this explains,
George said,
is why Orthodox Marxism-Leninism, in spite of all its ideals, always turned out to be not worth a shit. Why it's always betrayed the people wherever it established itself. And it explains why there's such an inevitable quality about America's drift toward totalitarianism.
Right, said Hagbard. America is the target now. The world will then be much as Orwell predicted in 1984.
They bumped him off after it was published, you know. The book hit a little too close to home. He was obviously onto them. The references to inner and outer parties with different teachings. O'Brien's speech about power being an end in itself. And they got him. Orwell, you see, ran across them in Spain, where they were functioning quite openly at one point during the Civil War. But artists also arrive at the truth through their imaginations if they let themselves wander freely. They're more likely to arrive at the truth the more scientific-minded people. You've just tied 200 years of world history up in a theory that would make me feel I should have myself committed if I accepted it,
said George.
But I'm drawn to it, I admit. Partly intuitively, I feel you're a person who's essentially sane, not paranoid. Partly because the orthodox version of history that I was taught in school never made sense to me. And I know how people can twist history to suit their beliefs, and therefore I assume that the history I've learned is twisted. Partly because of the very wildness of the idea. If I learned one thing in the last few years, it's that the crazier an idea is, the more likely it is to be true. I think that what you've been telling me is the truth, or a version of it. I don't know whether to trust you completely, but I've got my sign. If the Bavarian Illuminati don't exist, something does. So then, where do we go from here?
Hagbard smiled.
Spoken like a true homo neophilus, George. Welcome to the tribe. We want to recruit you because you're so gullible. That is, gullible in the right way. You're skeptical about conventional wisdom, but attracted to unorthodox ideas, an unfailing mark of a homo neophilus. The human race is not divided into the irrational and the rational, as some idealists think. All humans are irrational. But there are two different kinds of irrationality. Those who love old ideas and hate and fear new ones, and those who despise old ideas and joyfully embrace new ones. Homo neophobus and homo neophilus. Neophobus is the original human stock, the stock that hardly changed at all for the first 4 million years of human history. Neophilus is the creative mutation that has been popping up at regular intervals during the past 1 million years, giving the race little forward pushes, the kind you give a wheel to make it spin faster and faster. Theophilus makes a lot of mistakes, but he or she moves. They live life the way it should be lived. 99% mistakes and 1% viable mutations. Everyone in my organization is Neophilus, George. That's why we're so far ahead of the rest of the human race. Concentrated Neophilus influences without any neophobe dilution. We make a million mistakes, but we move so fast that none of them catch up with us. Before you get any deeper, George, I'd like you to become one of us.
Which means what?
Become a legionnaire in the Legion of Dynamic Discord.
George laughed.
Oh, that sounds like a gas, but it's hard to believe that an organization with an absurd name like that could build anything as serious as this submarine or work for such a serious end as foiling the ancient illuminated seers of Bavaria.
Hagbard shook his head.
What's serious about a yellow submarine? It's right out of a rock song. And everybody knows people who worry about the Bavarian Illuminati are crackpots. Will you join the Legion in whatever spirit you choose?
Certainly, said George promptly. Hagbard clapped him on the back.
Ah, you're our type, all right. Good. Back through the door you came then, turn right, and through the golden door.